One, two, three, four.
You, she has no right to call herself a true blood, and no right to stand in my presence. If she wishes an audience, let her earn it.
Agree.
Spare the rod, spoiling child, is it? Ex Machina, how are things looking with the Rainbow Jewel?
everything is proceeding as expected. At the current rate, the ritual should be complete in a matter of hours.
Well then, I suppose it's fulfilling its purpose admirably for a stolen relic. I'm going to step out for a bit. Just keep going with the ritual.
As you wish.
About a high roller lifestyle. This place makes Fiona's mansion in town look like a quaint summer villa. No wonder you wanted to get your castle back so badly. It's about as swank as they come.
You think so? Personally, I think it's almost too large. It's just me and Rue here, and the serving spirits. There's no way we can make use of all this space.
I guess it's all in how you look at it. Though looking around, I'm sort of surprised. I was expecting a bit more of a reception than this. After I got all pumped up, it feels like kind of a letdown.
I suppose you have a point. You'll get your chance for action, though. I feel the presence of many fiends deeper inside.
Princess Alwyn. Princess Alwyn, can you hear me?
Hey, isn't that voice...
Ralaira, is that you?
Of course it's me. Who else would be using telepathy to contact you? Rue got me up to speed on what's been happening. So you finally managed to dispel the barrier, I take it?
Naturally. In fact, we're in the castle right now. So, have your auguries and scrying turned up anything important?
They have. I've discovered where Marquis Zahar is holed up. He seems to be performing some sort of ritual in the castle's chapel.
What?
Wait, your vampire castle has its own chapel? How does that even work?
It's a chapel to Espina, goddess of the dark and the moon, of course. But what is he doing there?
I'm not sure myself, unfortunately, but I've got a very bad feeling about this. Don't let him complete the ritual. That's all the information I have for now.
Thanks.
Hey, Granny! At least let me get a few words in! Don't you worry, my princess. I'm coming to help you out, too! Just hold on and I'll be there before you know it!
Master Ragna! Alwyn! I'm coming with Rue to give you guys a hand!
It's like the two of you just can't sit still.
Wait a minute! Coming here is reckless, even for you guys.
I'll be accompanying these youngins, so don't you worry about them. Just keep your mind on what you're doing right now, and don't let your guard down.
Got it.
I'll keep that in mind.
Stay safe in there!
See you soon, Master Ragna!
Well, that kind of complicates things. Maybe we should just blow through and try to wrap up things here.
No argument from me. She mentioned the chapel specifically, though. I'm not sure what to expect, but this might get ugly.
Why? What have you got stashed in there?
It doesn't really matter if we can't get to him. It looks like he sealed off the way to the chapel. If we want to open that hall, we'll need to visit three particular areas of the castle.
Okay. So, what three areas? Maria's arms.
The terrace beyond the living quarters, the underground waterway that doubles as our dungeon, and the cemetery gardens. Once we've triggered the hidden mechanism in each location, our path to the chapel will be clear.
Got it. Looks like it's time for some good old-fashioned exploration. Seriously, though, a dungeon and a graveyard? Am I gonna have to whip some candlesticks for money, too?
Getting cold feet, are we?
You wish. Any treasure hunter worth his salt has seen more graves and dungeons than he can shake a stick at. Let's just pick one and get to work. The sooner we hit them all, the sooner we can get to the chapel. Then we can both give your uncle the ass-whooping he's got coming.
Now you're talking.
Over here!
Peace out! Peace out! listen.
Thank you.
Time to take a breather.
Welcome, welcome! You've got yourself a deal.
Another fight.
Well met, dear princess and her knight. Can you feel it? All around us hang the grudges and despair of the condemned. So, it's you. Aha! You did magnificently, destroying the barrier and storming the castle. Panache, what heroism! Allow me to offer you my congratulations, Alwyn.
Just what I always wanted, your approval.
And if it isn't little Ragna, my, you're exercising a commendable amount of restraint today. Where are your venomed words? Are you going to bark and lunge at me like a rabid mongrel again? Flecks of spittle and all.
Nice try, pretty boy, but you won't get the best of me twice. Listen up, because I've only got one thing to tell you. I'm gonna beat your ass so hard, the only thing you'll be able to move is your mouth. Then, you're gonna tell me everything. So I hope you're feeling chatty today.
Look at you with your game face on. That withering stare. So intense. But you have to realize, getting angry and trying too hard makes you look like such a simpleton.
Enough of this posturing. There's obviously some sort of bad blood between you and Ragna. I may not know the details, but at this point, I can hardly overlook it either. So, as the head of the Moonbriya clan, I command you. If we beat you here, you will tell us everything.
Hey now!
Goodness me. Not exactly a born negotiator, are you, Princess? You see, the way it usually works is that you would need to offer something I would like to entice me into such a wager.
I don't care how it usually works. Did you not hear me? I gave you my command. If we beat you here, you will tell us everything. Do I make myself clear?
Owen? Oh, I should have expected nothing less from the niece of Marquis Zahar. Very well then, Princess Alwyn. If by some idle chance or stroke of luck your pride and dignity prevail here, I shall share with you the whole sordid tale. Is that acceptable?
It is. What do you think, Ragna? Do you find these terms agreeable?
Yeah, I guess so. Sorry about this, Alwyn.
Honestly, to think I'd entertain such a generous wager. Don't get me wrong, though. It's not a bargain you're ever going to collect on.
What the?
Let's have a little fun, shall we?
A crimson blade?
Be careful, Ragna! That must be a fell blade. I'm feeling an incredible aura coming from it.
I shall show you.
Behold, Glamdring, the Soul Eater.
Have you already forgotten? I told you I'm a fair hand in the ways of the sword.
And now I intend to show you! Fall into the abyss!
Come on.
too cool to die. I admit defeat. Never did I imagine I could be brought to my knees by the likes of you.
Now, like you promised, you're gonna tell me everything you know. Right now!
Very well. I'm a man of my word.
But are you really sure this is what you want, Ragnar?
I mean, certainly I'll be able to answer many of the questions that have burned within you all these years. But once the answers take form on my lips, you can never go back. I can see the hesitation there in your eyes. Yes, it's possible you'll learn something you wish you hadn't. No.
Ignore his blathering, Ragnar. He's just trying to deceive you.
My dear princess, a proper lady should be seen, not heard. This is between me and the boy. Besides, didn't you say you knew nothing of this?
Don't try to mess with me. What are you getting at?
Far be it from me to beguile you. What I said is true. Deep down, you claim you want to know the truth, but in spite of all your bluster, you've yet to ask even a single question of me. Yes, indeed. I know you have questions. Questions that perhaps none could ever answer, save myself. I can tell you everything your heart yearns to know. All you have to do is ask.
Ragnar?
Ah, but it seems time's up. I shall take my leave here.
Damn you!
It does seem rather unsporting to vanish without offering up a single tidbit in acknowledgement of your victory. And so I'll tell you now that my dear little doll is keeping Marquis Zahar company in the chapel.
What do you mean by that?
Any more would be telling.
So long, Ragnar. Keep chewing on that for a while, won't you? You may be onto something, but are you really so sure the truth is what you want?
Ragnar, he...
Ah, damn it!
Ragnar?
Sorry, Alan. You went out of your way to get him to talk. All for my sake.
Think nothing of it. Back at the Forge Tower, something there brought back some painful old memories, didn't it? And whatever it is, Thermidor knows about it, and he's playing it for all it's worth.
Yeah, something like that. But look at me. I had my chance, and when the moment came, I couldn't even stammer out a single question.
Then, as strange as it may seem, maybe you should be grateful to him.
Huh?
You feel ashamed about not seizing that opportunity because you really do want to know the truth. If you were content to remain ignorant, you wouldn't feel the pangs of regret like you do right now. You may not have gotten your answers, but you learned something valuable about yourself, didn't you? If I'm mistaken, don't hesitate to tell me. After all, I'm not exactly knowledgeable of the world outside my castle, and I don't have much experience to speak of. I can't even begin to fathom what you've been through, or understand what you must be feeling right now. A man like that, all high and mighty as he is.
It's okay, Alwyn. Your assessment is pretty spot on. It's kind of freaky. Like you were reading my mind for a second there.
Oh.
Well, at least making our way to the chapel will give me some time to think. But I got this feeling, you know? Like when I get there, I'll find what I'm looking for. It all sounds like a jumble now, but I'll explain things when we get there. I promise.
Very well. I accept your promise. But if you break your word to me, you better be prepared, because I'll lay into you like a thunderbolt.
Deal. If I don't keep up my end, you can cuss me out till the cows come home.